July 14th, 2016, it's 9:40 a.m. And we got these storms coming in here on a site that we use generally, weather bug. There's a little statement about the severe or dangerous thunderstorm, but right after the headline of dangerous thunderstorm until whatever time, 10:07 or something like that, it says experimental. So I just question, you gotta question everything. There's my, it's an 8 foot tall, we measured it yesterday, sunflower. That looks like that tail, whatever it's called, sunflower. I thought it was mammoth. It might be mammoth, but I'm saying that the face of it looks like the tail.
That one in the front garden has a mammoth, I know that.
That one over there? In the back, where is it, right there? Yeah, the head of that is so heavy, it's leaned over. Sunflowers open up quite a bit around us, but the one on the west wall, which you can't really see from here, I'm not getting off the porch actually. That's how I want it, all the way around that and in the back there to the north. I'm going to take it back about another 12 feet back. I'm going to take this one and go over a little bit. You can see in the back where I've been trying to cut the grass, the wild grass and all that down. You can see the brown right there. That's about how far over I'm going to go toward the road and make it as thick as possible. That's all gonna be done like in October, November, in that time of the year. Try and use that tiller and just take four, or this here, I'm just gonna take two sticks and some twine. Two sticks and some twine and put it here and back there as straight as possible. I might go ahead and do the four like I'm gonna do back there and put it like so, two here and two back there. And then I got a walkway to go through. And then, like I said, go to about there. And I was gonna go right to the edge of that grass. That might be just about 4 inches this side of the grass, that high grass back there. All the way down, real thick again. Like, I can't show you right now because all the vegetation's come up in the garden. But you've seen on a previous video how thick the sunflowers are in the back wall, the west wall. You can see how thick they are back there, but they're so small. Supposed to be like our wind thing, but all this toxic cotton, and I'm gonna call it toxic cotton because that's what it is. It's from Monsanto. The farmer who does this out here is would be considered the son of the land owner. Says they're gonna be spraying this cotton every week with the toxic poison to kill off the insects, of course. And see, and then our garden is like 20 feet this side of that, and my sunflowers break off the wind a little bit, but not as much as I wanted to. Look at how thick the corn is right there. I got had four rows and had a raccoon go in there and tear it all up. It's messed up that corn, but we still should get us about 40 to 60 years of corn. I've got two rows to the left. They're still coming up. One is real close, and then the one after that I just planted probably about 2 weeks ago, about 3 weeks ago. I planted five. But the one was so close to the edge, it was stepped on, and it's no good now, of course. So we got four that are growing. That's probably about thigh high. And then all this other corn. Plant some zucchini out here again, because they said now mid-July is good to plant zucchini. I planted some beans, a bunch of beans, because beans are good for protein. We got a lot of beans, and they're growing pretty good, too, man. All the beans I've been planting have been coming up. I can't walk out there. I'm not walking out there. I should say I can, but I'm not going to walk all the way out there. I don't have a brace on or anything. But you can see all the beans right there. How well those things are growing. I had some I planted way early. I mean, well, late, because I planted them in the third week of April, and then May was in the 90s. I'm talking about mid-90s. And it burned them up, as you can see by the, well, I can't go out there and see it, but I've showed you also the brown leaves that were on them. Oh, about back there. Got flies flying on me out here. But then I just plant some more, and they're all coming up, and then my watermelon's coming up. So cucumbers, we got even a couple cucumbers on there right now. We've already picked about six. Last year we had so many in the back garden. See, it's number one. That's the number one garden. And then we have number two, and the back one's number three. We're gonna make it three and four. We're gonna cut that one in half. It just make it a little easier. It'll cut down a little bit, but like I said, look at the spacing we have right there with the beans and whatnot. So Don't know if we're going to do corn next year because we were told they weren't going to do corn around us. They got this toxic corn, cotton right up on us and soybeans on the far end. But then up on the hill, the other sun that they don't associate with, planted corn. So again, that's just going to could cross-pollinate. If it's left up for another year, it'll cross-pollinate and I'm not going to mess with it. But yeah, see, the Hummers have been out here eating because of the storm coming. One of our sunflowers I put out here, I'm not going off the porch. I keep saying I can't. I'm not going off the porch to get to find that sunflower right there. That's to get the hummingbirds as a treat if they want it. They've been going into the corn over there, actually. But the orange flower back there, that's the, let's see if I can find it on here now. That's the torch sunflower, the orange flowers right there. See videos from last year. Those get the large winged butterflies and they attract monarch butterflies, which last year we had 5 or 6 of them. Haven't seen any yet this year, but as difficult as it has been to keep them from being extinct or, you know, less. Hummingbirds go on them and honeybees especially. And that's another reason for all these sunflowers. There's nothing to go by the garden. It's just see honeybees and bees all over them sunflowers. And they pollinate everything in here, which is what's helping the watermelons and all that, you know, produce. The beans have been producing. The tomatoes are green. There's about 30 tomatoes out there. I can't see them from here again. There's just vaguely on the edge. You can see it. A couple tomato plants out there. There's about 11 tomato plants over there. The okra is all about 4 foot, 4 foot tall right there. Look at that thickness. I got this giant sunflower there. Got 3 or 4 in the back there. And got this mammoth one right here. So, but there's your threatening skies. I said I was getting off of Two Facebook because of the fact that, you know, we usually lose the internet. And I was pulling up the weather that I looked at for the radar. And guess what? We had no internet. Because about 2.5 miles that way is a tower. This is kind of somewhat asinine, and you can't really see it from here. But up in the tree there, I've shown in another previous video somewhere, there's a dish up there. Look, like a dish network or, you know, one of those satellite companies that you get internet from. I mean, cable from type. One up in that tree up there. And like I say, it goes about 2.5 to 3 miles that way. And when it's inclement weather, or if the wind blows 2 miles an hour sometimes, even we have sunny days, no wind, and boom, no internet because some kind of difficulties with the crazy glue holding the tower pieces or whatever out that way or something. Anyway, I've got enough rants about that place too, so. Okay, that's it, man. Oh, there's a video on there I put on, my wife had put on. About trucks with these martial law signs on the highway. You people better wake your ass up, because if you don't, you know, you deserve exactly what's coming. If you want to be stupid and pretend that it's all okay, it's not. The race thing is bullshit. It's being done purposely to get you agitated. We're all the same thing, folks. I mean, the person's got a different color skin, and that's the only difference. Don't get your panties in a wad. Don't listen to the damn mainstream media. I'm guilty of putting on Fox, but I put on MSNBC too. I don't put on CNN no more because they're bullshit as it is. They've been fakes for like years. At least a couple decades. But anyway, if you want to hear what the Democrats are going to say, you put on MSNBC. You want to hear what the Republicans are going to say, you put on Fox. I mean, you know, left, right, yes, no, salt, pepper, Diet Coke, no, regular Coke. It's the same thing, folks. Stop letting them play you for the idiots that they want you to be. There's a train over there. I see it just with 2 cars. Huh, I wonder what that is. They're covered small cars. Wow, that makes me think now. I think of those signs of martial law. Okay, that's going southwest. Okay, just so you know, southwest. Out of Jackson, Tennessee. Jackson, Tennessee is probably about 8 miles right on the other side of them trees.